Hey guys, it is me, Life Simmer, and welcome back to Let's Play The Sims 3 Ambitions. So it is such a beautiful winter day. I am obsessed with how pretty this town has been looking. In the previous part, Benkoto got tons and tons of his work equipment taken away by the repo man. So we definitely need to work on that a little bit. And Portia also has a case to go ahead and open up today about somebody who has a missing ring. So we're definitely going to have to check that out. And in the previous part, we also went over to Justin K's house, which is Isabella's potential lover. We also went to the graveyard with Alexander to see if any spirits would awaken for him. So I did a little bit of redecorating with the simoleons that we had. Unfortunately, you know, the house is still pretty barren, but I did do some things. So downstairs, I switched up the kitchen a little bit. I'm not sure what sort of theme I want to do in here. I'm kind of leaning more towards modern, but it still has a very, I guess, not colonial, but like modern family home sort of look, which I just don't think this family is going for. So I'm not sure what I want to do in here yet, but I switched things up just a teeny itty bitty bit. And then right here, I put in like a bathtub and just this for now. I put up our Christmas tree. If you don't celebrate Christmas, then you know what? We'll put down something else for you guys as well. And also, I put down a couple of like other little stuff, like little sitting chairs, a new coffee table. And then if we go upstairs, I gave Isabella kind of a new room. It's, you know, in the works as well. It is 6 days until spring, so we do have quite a bit of winter left, and it's already snowing really freaking hard. So Isabella, I'm going to have her head in here. Oh no, that bell might, Portia's stupid bike might be in the way of it. So let me just move this over a little bit. And Isabella is going to come over here and improve her fire alarm. And we also need to actually forget the fire alarm. Let's go ahead and improve our horsepower on the fire machine. Oh, can I not? Oh, I might need to actually move this a little bit. We're only at a level 1 horsepower, which is like asking to not get a good grade on our fires. So we're gonna go do that. And I also want her to get into sculpting a bit more. So she wants to make something worth at least 50 simoleons and make a brilliant sculpture. So I'm gonna go ahead and lock that in. Ben is only what? I think he's only like 30% through his time machine, which really, really sucks. She's going to be waking up soon. Alexander needs to go to bed, actually. So we're going to go send him to bed. And in the next part, we are going to be switching over to Cassandra and Bliss to go ahead and play them for a little bit. But he's going to go ahead and get into bed. He wants to watch a raccoon. Okay, dude, clearly you're a freaking freak. Just saying. But yes, we also need to train Bogatella a bit, because, you know, it would be nice to have a dog that actually knows how to sit, unlike my dogs. My dogs are smelly bulldogs. So, if you have a bulldog, then you know, they're like little people. Like, legitimately little lazy slobs. And I love them so much, because there's so much personality in such a little body. But, my dog is Gabby, in case you guys don't know who she is. And she is so cute. She is so, so cute. One of the cutest bulldogs I've ever seen, to be honest. But she is the most obedient one when it comes to tricks. She knows how to sit and lay down, and that is it. The other ones know how to sit, and that's it. But, you know, they're getting there. We can now maintain our fire truck and improve the horsepower to a level 2. We're going to go ahead and improve the horsepower again. I'd like to maintain the truck and the fire alarm as far as we can today, and also improve our horsepower as much as possible. Oh, we have a fire, actually. Uh-oh. And it is a building disaster. Oh my goodness. It's at the military base. So this is probably very serious. Okay, Isabella, let's go, girl. Let's go. All right, here we go, guys. We improved our horsepower. Let's see if we can tell. No, I cannot tell. Still seems like we're going extremely slow. Wow, we should really work on that, shouldn't we? yeah, it's probably a necessity to work on our horsepower today, but oh gosh, how far away is this? All right, here we are at the building disaster. I don't even want to know what's happening in here that it is called a building disaster. That is crazy. So she's going to go deal with that. I'm going to go ahead and have Portia begin her case. She's in a fairly good mood. I'll just have her go ahead and grab like a bowl of cereal or something. Oh, and Alexander. Oh, it's already 5 o'clock. Holy crap. He has available ghost work. So yes, we're going to go perform jobs with Alexander. Oh, it said something about Simbots. Sorry, I clicked out of that so quickly. But yes, Borgia is going to grab herself some frozen yogurt. And we're going to head out with the creepy man himself, who still has gotten, like, no sleep, hasn't had dinner or anything. So we're probably only going to perform, like, one job tonight. But, oh, that's not embarrassing. Totally not. He's going to get all the chiquitas on his little scooter, right? Yeah, totally. So with Alexander's love life, I kind of plan on doing a ghost relationship. I think that would be kind of fun. Odd things have been happening in my home. I believe there may be a ghost lurking about. Am I crazy? Could you scan a bit to see if somebody is lurking? That is terrifying, and this music is quite scary. Isabella hears some gears clanking. Okay, let's go ahead and find these ghosts. We can now use our spookometer with good use, so we're gonna scan for some spirits in his home, which is like the size of a freaking shoebox. Let's see, will they be in here? Oh, in here is one. How many are in here? Three? All three of them? I mean, it would make sense because his house is literally the size of a shoebox. This is like the size of a bedroom. I'm confused, poor thing. Okay, so we have three ghosts in here, and this one's wearing like a really odd hat. This hat looks like a bottle nipple, like a baby bottle pop. All right, and these ladies are wearing like medieval dresses and stuff, I guess. So her name is Nuwa. We have Nuwa, Eli, and Ida. So we're gonna try to evict these ghosts. We're going to convince her to move on. And I totally forget what these colors mean. I believe he... Oh, crap. I wish I knew. Oh, I wish I knew. I totally, totally forget. Oh, okay, so... I believe he's, like, normal. So I guess we'll try to put at ease about loved ones and then convince him to move on. But these two have different emotions. Okay, Alexander, talk to them. Talk to them. Yes, convince him to move on. Go on. All right, buddy. No need to growl at me, okay? No need to growl at me. We're gonna put him at ease. See if that will calm him down a little bit. Okay, we are going to talk about a full life and then convince him to move on. Okay, buddy. Okay, clearly he's not ready to move on. We're going to put at ease about loved ones again. We're going to talk about a full life. All right, all right. All right, all right. And then we are going to enthuse about sleeping in. Oh, okay, they're good friends now. So then I'm going to convince... Oh, they're best friends. Okay, buddy. Now I'm going to ask you to leave. All right. One is gone. They get really mad really quickly. Oh, honey, she took her hat off and she got in her bikini. Hey, so this is the type of ghost eviction this is going to be. We're going to put her at ease about her loved ones. We're going to talk about a full life. We're going to talk about the snow. We're going to talk about the cold. And then we're going to convince her to move on. Huh? Oh, we can be friends with them. No, we can't actually. Never mind. I wish. Hi, how are you? You need to get out of here right now, miss. This is not your house. Go, leave. Take your friend with you while you're at it. Can I ask you a question though, miss? Where do you get that hat? Because I want one. I like this old thing. I got it from Forever 21 back in the old days. No way. I'm just having a conversation with myself. Casual, no biggie. But come on. They're like taking the freaking time having some horrifying quality mac and cheese performed by Ida. Ida is not going to be nicely asked to leave. Since she burnt mac and cheese, she is getting... She's going to be banished with the banshee banisher. Sorry. You're going to go out the hard way, honey. Okay. Nuwa? Nua, whatever, you're about to get banished too, honey. Both of you are. I'm not going to be nice now. You gotta go. Let's go. Let's go, ladies. Yes, you guys are having the hard way out because you wanted to freaking sit here and waste my time. Well, I'm already exhausted. I didn't get much sleep last night. You two are now going out the hard way. Sorry, not sorry. Goodbye. Yeah, whatever. Goodbye. Yep, see ya. Smashing you through the freaking house as well. Let's go. You're leaving. I don't care. Bye. Get her, Alexander. Get her. Alexander. Yes. Okay. So that just proves to all the other ghosts, do not take us as a joke because we will just suck you up like it's nothing, honey. All right, Ida, it is your turn for burning the mac and cheese. You deserve this. Bye. All right, well, work is done. Our work is done here. All of that for 320 simoleons? Are you freaking kidding me? I just wasted 5 hours of this poor guy's time sucking these freaking ghosts up, and they were being really sassy. They're, you know what? We're just gonna go ahead and, you know, go get a bowl of that horrifyingly quality mac and cheese. Oh, just kidding. Just kidding. We're going to go home and make something. But Ben Koto has finished making the time machine. Hoop-dee-dee-doop-dee-doop. So we're going to put down the time machine because we can. Let's go ahead and put it down right here where it was. Take that, Repo Man. Take that. And we are going to travel to the future tonight because we can. he wants to travel to the past and the future. Yeah, so we're gonna be doing those. I'm so excited. He's gonna go Power Rangers. I just said go so many times. It is 1 a.m. while I'm filming this, so don't mind me. But he's gonna go get himself some yogurt. My Sims always eat yogurt. I just really like yogurt. I really love yogurt. But we are going to go to sleep. Also, go ahead. Actually, she'll make a pizza. That sounds so yummy. She's going to make a pepperoni pizza. Portia has not started her interview yet, but we'll do that in the morning considering it's already. Shall we not? Like I was saying, we'll just go ahead and start that off in the morning. She wants to snoop for clues as well today, or sometime soon, so we'll be doing that. But let's just go ahead and get her motives up a bit. Maybe hit on Ben. You know, Portia probably wants a little woohoo. A lot of you guys were telling me to have Portia go ahead and kill the Repo Man. Are you guys down for that? Because I am. Oh. Who died? This music is so sad. Oh. That music is tragic. And because Generations is starting soon, that just makes me think of in Generations when like a family member dies and it's just going to play that music. Anyways, I wouldn't mind having a serial killer on my hands. I think that'd be kind of fun. So I might be, you know, making Portia a little psycho. But Alexander, you are in such bad mood. Go ahead and use the restroom. The pizza's done as well, so go ahead and grab yourself a plate. And then after that, he's going to take a nice bath. And I believe Dogatella needed a bath as well. Tomorrow's going to be Dogatella's day in this house. Yeah, we have a lot to do tomorrow morning, but I do want Ben to actually travel to the past and future and everything tonight. So I'm going to have him come over here, and what we're going to do is first travel to the future. So we're just going to have him... No, go pee before you go to the future. 2 more days, Snowflake Day will be upon us. We'll eat lots of food, throw a party, or decide on a venue to celebrate this joyous holiday among friends and family. Since Alexander does have family and we are dating a few people, I think it is necessary to have a little holiday party or something. I think I may make like a venue or something to actually celebrate it at. I think that would be kind of nice. But until then, we're going to have Portia go to sleep now, Isabella as well, and Alexander needs to go to the restroom and take a shower and all of that. But all right, we are now going to travel to the future because that is a huge part of Ambitions and also a Simbot. We're definitely going to be working on our Simbot rather soon. But the cool thing about the future is you actually can get a child that way, which is really, really neat. And I think that would just be great for Ben, having like a kid. And it's kind of weird because like the child comes out looking practically identical to the person who travels to the future. So it's really neat. And it comes out as a young adult too. So we wouldn't be like going through all the children stages and everything, which is unfortunate because, you know, I'm a big maternal instincts, not instincts, but I'm like very maternal. I treat my dogs like they're babies because they are my babies. So I feel like when they're toddlers and children, I'm just kind of like, oh, all over it. But, you know, still nice. Ben got picked up by some aliens while exploring a derelict space station, but they turned out to drop Ben off at the nearest outpost. Despite the creepiness and total silence, it was very interesting to see all the shapes and sizes of future robots. Cool. The Keeper of Time almost caught up with Ben at New Francisco while he was just listening. Oh, what happened? He was at the cyber bar. Luckily, he was able to escape. Ben was learning how to play a new board game from a cyborg when the VU, the destroyer, showed up to eat the spaceship they were on. Luckily, Ben jumped back into the time stream before becoming lunch. He earned 510 simoleons and he came back with 510 simoleons. Wow, okay. So we are now going to... Ben has traveled too recently and still is recovering. Okay, so in 4 hours, we will be able to travel again. So I'm going to have him go to bed and we'll travel in the morning. So I'm going to go ahead and skip until the morning, guys. I'm going to send Alexander to bed as well. And I will see you guys. All right,
guys.
Then.
So good morning. It is currently 7:25 and Portia has woken up. She's taken a bath. She's done all that she needs to do today. So she is now going to head to Tay very early in the morning and begin her interview. And apparently Dumbo says, "What's your sign? Looks like you and I were meant to be." No. We have people to kill, so return stolen item, bull, must do. So she's gonna take her scooter a go glow and we're gonna go interview this guy early in the snowy morning.
Hello, sir. I potentially may steal from you one of these days.
Oh my goodness, good gracious, what is that?
Okay. But hi, Tay. So tell me, what happened to this ring that apparently was stolen?
I think it was her in the back. Tay Bayless left the ring in the dining room. Okay, so like right here. Then left for work. The cops couldn't find any evidence, but I'm not sure the fuzz can explain a ring that isn't made of dough and covered in sugar.
I should dust for fingerprints in the dining room. Okay, so apparently it went missing literally right here. Oh. Okay, she did it, clearly. Animals naturally have, like, that instinct. So, yeah, let's go ahead and, I guess we can take things for evidence? What the? Why is she about to pass out? Why is she passing out? Oh, from a boring conversation? Oh, wow. Okay. okay. Oh, she's a firefighter? Okay, this is really awkward. Hey, yeah, I'm on the case. Let me just... Portia, can we wake up? Thank you. So, I guess we need to scan this room. How does one take fingerprints? It says we can take things as evidence, but can't swipe anything when you're being watched. So, do I need to swipe stuff when people are out of the room? Is that what I need to do? I think that is. So, yeah, if you could walk out of the room or something. Oh, there we go. We can dust for prints. We can dust the bookshelf. We can't dust the table. Can we dust any of the chairs? No, no, and no. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and dust this. She sneezed. All right.
Are we getting any good evidence here? Okay, cool. I found the prints, but they don't seem to match with any of the prints in my limited files. I should stop by the police station to run these prints against their database. Okay, so we need to go to the police station and insert our fingerprints into their database. So we're going to go analyze our prints this morning. And she actually got some job experience. She just might get a promotion by the end of this part, which would be very exciting. Okay, Isabella is going to rise and shine. I do want to give Dogapella? I do want to bathe Dogatella. I also want to work on my horsepower a little bit. So we should maintain these first. Okay. Ben can officially go travel to the past. I kind of want to travel to the future again. I really like the future with the possibility that we might get the baby. I kind of like that. Oh, and this is bad quality now. So I should probably throw this away. He is going to have some juice really quickly. Alexander, go back to bed. Go back to bed. Nobody wants you awake right now. All right. So let's have our cereal this morning and then let's go travel to the future. Casual, no biggie. All right. And we are going to travel to the future. And I also, right here, the mystery of the naked ring finger. There are not one, but two sets of prints on this ring. One set belongs to my client, Tay Bayless. The other belongs to Jade Greenwood. Looks like I need to pay a firm visit to Jade Greenwood regarding the ring. Okay, so apparently this ring has, of course, the victim in the case, and apparently this girl, Jade. So we're gonna go confront our suspect. And by the way, Jade sounds like a gorgeous name, so. Oh, is she in work or something? Where is she? She's in the club. Mm-mm, honey. Nope. She is definitely higher on the suspect list now. When you are freaking at a club at noon, there is an issue. There is an issue. And she's reading a book. Let me in. Does she, like, work there or something? Really? Can you, like, come outside of it so I can confront you? Whatever. It's noon. She's going to go get lunch. No biggie. She'll head over to the diner and just go ahead and eat alone really quickly. Okay. We're about to head to the future again. And did she improve this? Yes, she... No, she didn't. Get to work. Alexander's back in bed. And yeah, we're just going to go ahead and wait for her to finish lunch. Ben was learning how to play a new board game. Yeah, whatever. All right, she finished doing that. Oh, what the? No. Oh my gosh. Jeez. Ben was browsing in a floating marketplace when an ancient junk bot came up to him and gave him a huge hug saying thanks for everything before toddling off. That was weird. Okay, so can I still travel? Yes, we can travel again. Is this them trying to say I should travel to the past? I guess we should. All right, he's going backward. Oh my gosh. Let's try again. Oh my, why? Let's try the future again. Is he like not allowed in right now? Okay, one more time. Okay then, apparently it is just, it's not happening today. I was really excited, but apparently no, we're not allowed. She's having lunch? Yeah, she should be. And we still can't confront stupid Jade. Oh my gosh, come on. Ooh, there's an igloo though. Ooh, we're gonna go take a nap. Yeah, honey, go take a nap while you wait for Jade. Yes, you get in there. Oh no. Oh, we have to make an igloo. Oh, she wants to warm up. We have to. We're gonna. Oh, look how cute she's being. We have to go ice skating and make an igloo and a snowman. We have to. Okay. She is going to, I guess, go make dinner for everybody. Let's make like a stew or something. Something nice and. Okay. We can make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. No, that's not what I want. Okay. I guess make everybody. None of this sounds good. I wish you knew how to make, like, a stew. That would be nice. Let's head to the grocery store really quickly. or the bookstore and shop for some new recipes because I'm sick of eating the same freaking crap. Alexander, do me a big favor. Since you're such a neat freak, go ahead and give Dogatella a bath because I did want to bathe Dogabella today. Dogabella. Dogabella. Still cannot confront Jade. She's a difficult one. But yeah, we're going to head in here really quickly and look at... Where is it? Cooking. Right there. Some recipes. We can make ratatouille, chili con carne, vegetarian chili, vegetarian fish and chips, mushroom omelets. That's a good one. Fish and chips, hot and sour soup. That's what I want. And it is a level 3 required and we're a level 4. So we'll also do cookies, fruit parfaits, and that's as far as we can go right now. So let's go ahead and head home. We will cozy on up inside. And I think tonight we're going to learn how to make hot and sour soup. And tomorrow morning, before she makes breakfast, I will make her learn how to make fruit parfaits. Because I think that'd be really, really yummy in the morning time. And hopefully he's inventing something good over there. Portia, can we confront our suspect now? No. I think at 5 p.m. when the grind opens, we'll be able to. Oh, come on. I was about to have her go make dinner. She was going to go relax and read a little book. I guess we have to respond to the emergency. This sucks. It's a large house fire too, so we are on the job. Oh, and cool. Ben just sold his drinking llama. Congratulations. We made 8 simoleons. Okay, and we can now go confront our suspect as well. Oh, so much is going on right now. Alexander has work and he's in such a bad mood. He needs to eat. Oh, so much is going on right now. There's 3 trapped freaking Sims. Oh my goodness. Let's see the house. Is it a nice little house? Oh, looks kind of fancy, I suppose. Let's see. Where are the trapped Sims? Okay, we have one in a bedroom. One literally by the front door. Okay, I am judging. And we have another one in the bedroom. So, first you need to put out the fire. So, let's go ahead and extinguish this. Extinguish this. Who knew a fire could be this destructive? Please do what you can to preserve what I hold so dearly to my heart. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and put these out before you can get the people, which makes no sense. You have to put out the house fire. So let's try to do this. Extinguish that. Alright, one more. We got this. Easy peasy. Alright, now we can go inside and rescue the Sims. Let's go ahead and break down the first door. You would think you'd be able to just... Oh, wait. We have to break through every single one. Okay, here we go. Convince her to run, even though she's by the front door. Get out of here. Homebound studying objectives. Study at home. Honey, we got real issues right now. All right, go. All right, here we go again with Mr. Jared. Oh, I have to convince him to run too? Dude, the fire's out. You don't even have to run anymore. All right, here we go. I just want a good grade. All right. Cool. We've earned quite a bit of simoleons in this part. She is in such a bad mood. We're going to use your toilet. So I hope you don't mind. I just saved all of you. We're using your toilet. Oh, okay. So Ben actually learned how to make a improved airbender. Woo. Great. I thought it was going to be like, Ben learned how to make a Simbot. I would poop my pants, but nope. Nope. All right. So she's going to be heading home. We're going to go confront our suspect here at the grind. I really wanted to visit Cassandra, but so much was going on. I'm like not even going to work with him right now, unfortunately. He needs to eat and stuff, actually. But here we are confronting Jade. And apparently Jade Greenwood claims to be innocent as well as a good friend of Tay Bayless. It appears the two had coffee the other day. I should question Tay to see if Jade Greenwood's story checks out. Okay, so she says that they're good friends, but who knows? They could literally be enemies for all we know. So we are going to head out. Can these two take care of themselves really quickly while I'm on the case with Portia. Alexander, go feed yourself. Go eat. Have yourself some mac and cheese. Ben, have yourself some brain. Yes, go ahead and eat some brain. And Isabella, I really, really, really want you to make something good. So everybody's just going to eat really simplistic things right now because I want her to learn some cool recipes. And then when she's done with that, she's going to learn how to make fruit parfaits for the morning. And then tomorrow she'll learn how to make some hot and sour soup. But yeah, back over to Portia. Since we are going to be ending this part really, really soon, we're going to ask him about the coffee visit. Hello, Mr. Tay. It's me again. Oh, hey, Justin. This is what you do when we can't come, when we can't find you. This is what Justin is doing. Good to frickin' know. When you say you're going to be out of town for 48 hours, we're going to come here. Wow, what a joke. What a joke. I'm curious if we ask him to hang out if he'll say he's busy. Seems our suspect was telling the truth. Strange that Tay Bayless would leave out such a significant detail. Something seems fishy. I should snoop around Tay's house and see what I can find. Oh my. Okay, so Tay, what is he trying to do? Is he trying to get some money for insurance on that ring or something? Because we up to you. Look, she's giving him like a stank eye. We are up to you. But alright guys, I am going to go ahead and end this part here. In the next part, we are going to find out if Tay is telling the truth or not. I guess I will see you guys then. I love you all so very, very much, and I will see you all next time. Bye guys!
So very much for watching this video. To subscribe, you can go ahead and hit that button down there, and don't forget to give this video a big fat thumbs up, because that's always nice. And if you would like to watch more of my videos, you can go ahead and click on my face. Once again, thank you so much, and